Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. With the booster that we saw last video that landed for a record 19th time, SpaceX posted some information. The first post says the Falcon Fleet's Life Leader rocket completed its 19th and final launch and landing on December 23rd. This one reusable rocket booster alone launched to orbit two astronauts and more than 860 satellites, totaling 260 plus metric tons in approximately 3.5 years. Then the next post has some unfortunate news about the booster. It says during transport back to port early this morning, the booster tipped over on the drone ship due to high winds and waves. Newer Falcon boosters have upgraded landing legs with the capability to self-level and mitigate this type of issue. John Krause got some shots of the booster, or at least what remains, on the drone ship, and it's a real shame that this booster was lost. Gav Cornwall posted some information related to what happened to cause the booster to tip over. He said, from what we know from various tweets, B1058 lacked self-leveling legs. In rough seas, it's difficult to fully latch all arms of Octagrabber to the booster. This was true on this final voyage. I can see some chains, so it looks like SpaceX tried to strap it down where the arms didn't latch, which we've seen many times, but it just wasn't enough for the sea state on this one and became a weak point. SpaceX's VP of Launch shared some more detailed information about the self-leveling leg technology. He said, tippy boosters occur when you get a certain set of landing conditions that lead to the legs having uneven loading. Heavy wind or sea state can cause the booster to teeter and slide, which can lead to even worse leg loading. In this state, securing with the Octagrabber is super challenging and often only partially successful. We came up with self-leveling legs that immediately equalize leg loads on landing after experiencing a severe tippy booster 2 years ago on Christmas first flight of 1069. The fleet is mostly outfitted, but 1058, given its age, was not. It met its fate when it hit intense wind and waves, resulting in failure of partially secured Octagrabber less than 100 miles from home. We can still hopefully expect to see the Falcon Heavy mission launch this coming week. The Falcon Heavy USSF 52 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 29th at 1:07 a.m. UTC or Thursday 28th at 8:07 a.m. EST. Then, just a matter of hours later, we can hopefully expect to see a Starlink mission. The Starlink 636 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 29th at 4 a.m. UTC or Thursday 28th at 11 p.m. EST. Then, later in the week, we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 79 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 31st at 3:17 a.m. UTC or Saturday 30th at 10:17 p.m. EST. Looking at the Cameron County website, there are currently possible closures for Friday 29th, Wednesday 3rd and Thursday 4th, hopefully for some Booster 10 testing. They also still have the temporary closures for tomorrow, Thursday 28th and Friday 29th. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.